This video is provided by the College of Graduate Studies at UCF. In this video, I will review the requirements for using references and demonstrate how to apply the appropriate formatting changes. Each source cited in the text must be included in the list of references. References may not include items not cited within the document. The heading title should be centered in all caps. References should either be single-spaced with an extra single space between citations, or double-spaced with no extra space between entries. Do not use the word continued as a heading or indication of multiple page references. We prefer the use of a hanging indent for each citation, but discipline-specific style manuals may have other preferences. References may also be collected by chapter instead of in one section at the end of the document. In this case, each reference section should be treated as a last subheading of the chapter, and there should not be a total list of references at the end of the document. For this tutorial, I will first demonstrate how to format your references according to the single-spaced option. Then I will demonstrate the double-spaced option. In the Word document, turn on the Show Hide All Formatting button to show any pre-existing formatting. To format the references, I'm going to highlight my references and go to the Home tab of the ribbon and click the small gray arrow in the bottom right corner of the paragraph section. In this menu, you can change the indentation to a hanging indent unless your style guide does not require it. In the Indentation section, select Special and choose Hanging from the drop-down menu. The preview window should show a hanging indent. Since we're starting with the single-spaced option, you'll also want to go to the Spacing section and change the line spacing to single. Because we also need an extra space between single-spaced entries, change the spacing after to 12-point to insert one line of space. Click OK until you return to the document. If you prefer to have your references double-spaced, you'll follow a very similar process to the single-spaced option. In the Word document, turn on the Show Hide All Formatting button to show any pre-existing formatting. To format the references, I'm going to highlight my references, go to the Home tab, and click the small gray arrow in the bottom right corner of the Paragraph section. In this menu, you can change the indentation to a hanging indent unless your style guide does not require it. In the Indentation section, select Special and choose Hanging from the drop-down menu. The preview window should show a hanging indent. Since we're using the double-spaced option, you'll also want to go to the Spacing section and change the line spacing to double. Make sure to set the space before to 0-point, as well as the space after. Click OK until you return to the document. This concludes the video tutorial for references. If you have any further questions, please use the ETD help request form available through the Thesis and Dissertation Services website. In the next video, I will cover the use of page numbers.